heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the North Texas Mean Green and the Wisconsin Badgers. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Badgers are the highly favored team in this one, Dick. Still, what are the keys for the game?
Well, the keys should be simple tonight, Brad. First of all, beware of turnovers. Protect the basketball. You want to minimize the amount of free possessions that you give to the opposition. Second of all, grab the boards, baby. Make it a habit. And lastly, execute defensively. Don't get caught going for the big steals or the big blocks.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny. But
his shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. The power forward takes the pass. And one too many dribbles and a steal. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Fed the low block. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
On the dribble, gives it up. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
A high screen.
Great anticipation defensively.
The small forward gets the pass. For two, perfectly executed. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. In the paint.
The game is changing, Brad. These days, guys are consistently playing above the rim.
Trying to pack it inside.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
Got the shot if he wants it. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Oh, yes. There's a double team waiting there. Number three comes up with it. He'll regroup the offense. Inside. Fakes the shot. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Inside. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, you spin back the other way.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good off.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Dickie still applying great pressure on the dribbler. There they come with a double team to stop it. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way?
Up and inside.
Number 45 takes the feed. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Up fake.
The pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
The ball goes out of bounds. With the ball.
Gotta Takes some pride on a defensive end.
Good job defensively. Shows patience waiting for the reset. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Number 32 was pounded on his way up. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Thanks, Aaron. Routine. Both free throws go. Number three wants the fans to keep cheering.
I think he feels the importance of this offensive possession.
He nails the shot. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Buried it.
You gotta let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit. The Badgers seem to be living the good life these days, Dick. With all their recent success, now they're regulars at the NCAA tournament.
Postseason is the time to shine, and they've really excelled of late. Only one basket away from the crowd being absolutely thrilled.
Number one steals the ball.
It's not uncommon to have a few high risers on your team these days. The game has definitely changed in that regard.
Number 45 with the fake. Here's a double team. Both teams are looking to get something going here.
The frustration right there.
The point guard gets the ball. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Turns it over. For two. They still don't score. Problem with that when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
They'll work it around the arc. Number 32 is fired up right now emotionally.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Tries for two and off the mark. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Controlling the ball from downtown. Wisconsin are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He attempts the trifecta. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
There's a high screen. He shoots from the top of the key. Goes.
Here's one for the highlight reel.
Perimeter. Gave it up. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Snatches it away.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Inside.
Number 42. They spent right now emotionally, Dick.
Hey, he may need some encouragement from one of his teammates. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He shoots from the angle, jumps into the defender. He puts it in with contact and all.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have help.
With a great block. Dribble, gives it up. Stolen away. Defense got it after knocking it loose. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. He missed. At halftime, the Badgers are ahead by two. This one's been a nail-biter so far, Dick. What play do you think set the tone in the first half, in your opinion?
I picked this basket in a pay for the highlight of the first half. We saw lots of inside scoring in the first half, and I think it's going to be the key for both teams in the second half.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. North Texas has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turning over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
The shot. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick T.O., baby.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. There's the pick. For the bucket. He's definitely hogging the ball like you hog the microphone.
Hey, sure he is. I can hear snorting from here.
Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
The three, way off target. They're working around the perimeter. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. Gave it up. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork beating him to the spot.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Wisconsin are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they gotta keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
He pump fakes. He tries a jump hook. Rims out. The point guard receives the ball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to, so, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot. Step out on that screener.
Tries for two. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Number three is whistled for the foul. First team foul. On the dribble, gives it up. They'll work it around the arc. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Gave it up. The point guard receives the pass for two. The Badgers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
The shooting guard handles the pass. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Steal. Number one is seemingly at an emotional low right now.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two.
I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
They work the perimeter. On the inside. Goes up for two. The chanting continues.
Well, ultimately, the goal is to win. The crowd feels as though they are a big part of it, too.
Dick, this crowd will go silly if they can get some points this trip.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
The perimeter way out on top, controlling the ball. He shoots from the elbow, off the rim and no good.
High post screen, gonna use it.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Erin. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Second shot, good. went away from the post and goes the other way. There's the fake. For two.
Couldn't put it in off the screen inside. Tough love. You can appreciate this more after watching the replay. Dump it inside.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Rims out. The power forward handles the feed. Fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. And he missed. Takes the pass in the paint. Number 20 steals the ball. Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. Jumped in front to take it away. Great job of getting down the floor.
Yeah, they wilted the fast break.
Faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Fake. They move it into the front court. For the deuce. In and out. On the outside. Here's a nice face-up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
And the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Baby hook doesn't go. On the dribble, gives it up. And a momentary look from three-point land. Number one with the foul. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Puts it up. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him.
Working it around the perimeter. Too much. That's a foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
He shoots from the elbow.
You need to create as many possessions as possible, so keep fouling.
It's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? And the clock stopped with a foul. Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Yet another foul. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
He goes to the line for the first time.
Got it.
They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Makes the second shot.
It's all about scoring here if they want a chance at winning.
The Mean Greens
call a timeout. And let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
Shot clock is dead. Guns up the deep one. Off the rim and no good. Now they'll bring it up. And the clock stopped with a foul. Number 45. He'll go to the line. He misses it. We've got a timeout here. Change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Pulls the trigger.
Better foul quick.
And yet another foul. With the freebie. He makes the front end of the 1-1. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Makes the shot.
Give yourself a chance with a score here.
Floor. Now they work it around the perimeter. From top of the circle, he shows the sweet touch. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Hits the second. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Get ready to resume the action. Just hoping for the best. Can't get it to go. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on a free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Wisconsin played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.